سلام 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 سلام. Peaceful, peace.
You are watching Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Oh, you who believe, give charity for the pleasure of Allah, the pleasure of Allah. Oh, you who believe, read the Quran every night of Ramadan, night of Ramadan. Welcome, O Ramadan, it is Ramadan, it is Ramadan.
Dear brothers and sisters in Islam and humanity, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace, the mercy and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. Welcome to the show Ramadhaan, a date with Dr. Zakia. I'm your host Yusuf Chambers, and today we will be discussing the topic, common errors committed by Muslims during the month of Ramadhaan. So without further ado, let's ask the first question of Dr. Zakir Naik. Dr. Zakir, what are the reasons behind Muslims continually falling into these same errors, Ramadan after Ramadan?
Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain. The main reason that Muslims keep on committing the same errors in the month of Ramadan regarding the rules and regulations of fasting is lack of knowledge of the deen, of the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the major reason for this lack of knowledge is because most of the Muslims, they do not read the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They do not read the Quran with understanding. Neither do they read the hadith, the authentic sayings of the last and final messenger Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What the Muslim should do is read the Quran with understanding, read the sayings of the Prophet and the seerah of the Prophet. Then inshallah, at least we will have the basic knowledge of our deen, including the rules and regulations of fasting. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He always opens up His pathway. He gives guidance for the Muslims, but there is a criteria. To whom does He guide? Allah says in the Quran, in Surah An-Kabut, chapter number 29, verse number 69, that those who strive in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who do jihad fi sabilillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens His pathways for them. So the criteria for us to get the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the criteria for us where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open up our pathways is to strive in His way, to do jihad fi sabilillah. And Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 43, as well as Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 7, Allah says, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهَلِ الزِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ, which means, if you do not possess, or if you doubt, then ask the person who possesses the knowledge. If you doubt anything, ask the person who is knowledgeable. And alhamdulillah, we have in our ummah several Muslims who are scholars in this deen. So it's our duty to ask these scholars, these people who have the knowledge of Islam regarding the rules and regulations of our deen. As far as fasting is concerned, which is one of the important pillars of Islam, every Muslim should know at least when is the time for fasting, what are the basic rules and regulations. And today, in this age of science and technology, it's very easy to find. It is only the negligence of a Muslim that makes him unaware of these things. It's very easy today to know when is the time for fasting, when does the fast begin, when is the time for suhur, when is the time for iftar, for breaking the fast, what are the things that break the fast, etc., etc. It is mainly due to the negligence and ignorance of the Muslims that we regularly keep on falling and committing the same mistakes.
Furthermore, what are the common errors that are made by Muslims during the holy month of Ramadan?
The common errors committed by the Muslims in the month of Ramadan can be broadly classified into four categories. The first category is the common errors committed by Muslims regarding the obligatory rules and regulations of fasting. The second category is the common errors committed by Muslims which are contradictory to the sunnah of fasting. The third category is the errors committed by Muslims mainly due to neglecting the obligatory duties in Islam and indulging in acts which are prohibited. And the fourth category is the other common errors committed by Muslims in the month of Ramadan.
Clearly, Dr. Zaki, it's going to be difficult for us to discuss all of the common errors made by Muslims during the month of Ramadan in this one interview. But over the next 32 days, we will, inshallah, try to cover those issues. But could you just state or list the most grievous mistakes made by Muslims in the month of Ramadan?
As far as the common errors that fall in the first two categories, inshallah, we'll be discussing in detail in the next, inshallah, 32 days. I will, inshallah, speak about the common errors committed in the third and fourth category.
Before we discuss categories 3 and 4, can we at least list the most common errors from sections 1 and 2?
The most grievous amongst the errors in the first category, that is errors committed regarding the obligatory rules and regulations of fasting, is the most common is that Muslims, many a times, they don't do the niyyah for fasting. Intention is very important. Without niyyah, without intention, the fasting is not accepted. So making intention is obligatory. And we'll be discussing this, inshallah, in detail, inshallah, tomorrow. The second error is that many a times, Muslims, even after the Fajr Azan has started, yet they continue eating. And they think that the end of suhoor time is only at the end of the Fajr Azan. In fact, the moment the Fajr Azan starts, the moment the beginning of dawn starts, the suhoor time ends. So this is error which normally nullifies or invalidates the fast. The third error in the first category is that many people, they delay paying their zakat al-fitr. And many times they pay after the Eid al-Fitr Salah. If we pay the Zakat al-Fitr after Eid al-Fitr, then it is like normal charity. It does not come under the Zakat al-Fitr. So these three are the most grievous in the first category. The common errors committed in the second category, that is errors that are contradicting the sunnah of the fasting, is number one. Many people, they skip their suhoor. Some people, they have an early suhoor. That is, they have the suhoor 1 or 2 hours before the Fajr time. In fact, suhoor is a blessing. Every Muslim should have it. And the Prophet said, we should delay the suhoor as much as possible. We should have it till just before the Fajr time. The third mistake committed by Muslims in this category is that they delay opening their fast. They delay the iftar. And our Prophet ﷺ said that the people will be good as long as they hasten in breaking the iftar. That means immediately after sunset, they should break the iftar. The fourth common error in this category is that many Muslims, they read unauthentic dua during iftar. The most authentic dua, as far as iftar is concerned, is Zahab al-Zama, Wabtallati Uruku, Wasabat al-Arj, Inshallah. Which means that my thirst is quenched, the veins are moistened, and The ajr is near, inshallah, God willing. The reward is near, God willing. And some people, when they read this dua for breaking the fast, they say it before breaking the fast. Before they put their date in the mouth, they say this, and it's contrary to the meaning. The meaning says that my thirst has been quenched. Zahaba zama waqtallati uruku. My thirst has been quenched and the veins have been moistened. Your thirst cannot be quenched before breaking the fast. So normally it should be said after you eat the khujur, after you have water and you're satisfied, maybe after some minutes after you break the fast, then you can eat this dua. Zahaba zama waqtallati uruku wa sabat al ajr inshallah, which means my thirst has been quenched, the veins have been moistened, the reward is near, inshallah, God willing. The sixth common error made by Muslims in this category is that many Muslims, they eat excessively during iftar, and many of them even eat throughout the night. The seventh common error is that many of them, they are negligent as far as Taraweeh is concerned, because Taraweeh is not a fard. They think it is no problem if a Muslim misses Taraweeh. Though Taraweeh is not a fard, it's a very important sunnah. And a Muslim who misses Taraweeh is missing a great deal of reward. And many Muslims who perform Taraweeh, they read Taraweeh very fast. 10 miles per hour. They try and finish it in a short time. And they defeat the purpose. In fact, you should read with a moderate pace, so that people understand and they grasp the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ninth common error is that those who go for itikaf in the mosque, many of them, they socialize during itikaf, as though it's a time to meet people and friends, which is totally contrary to the sunnah. The tenth common error is that many of the Muslims think that the Laylatul Qadr is on the 27th night of Ramadan, and they only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this night. In fact, the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, search for the Laylatul Qadr in the odd nights of the last 10 days, the last Ashra, the 10 days. Therefore, Laylatul Qadr can fall either on the 21st night, or 23rd, or 25th, or 27th, or 29th. So this is one of the common errors made by Muslims. The 11th common error is that they spend their time during Ramadan in unproductive work, rather than spending in zikr and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They should spend their time rather for offering, besides the compulsory salah, the nawafil, the voluntary salah, the sunnah salah. The 12th error made by the Muslims is that they should do dua. The 13th is, they should ask for forgiveness. This month of forgiveness. 14th is, they should read the Quran as much as possible to get the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The 15th is that they fast and they keep themselves hungry, but basically they're not mentally prepared for that fast. And it is as though they're staying hungry. But the main purpose of fasting, to acquire taqwa, is not obtained. This was in brief regarding the second category.
And now, brothers and sisters, we'll have a short break. Inshallah, see you after the break.
It is Ramadan.
Ramadan beckons us to give our zakat, an important fard and a pillar of Islam. Several fatwas of distinguished scholars of Islam worldwide state that zakat can be given to support a non-profit Islamic satellite channel whose aim is to spread the truth of Islam. Every dollar you contribute helps Peace TV to refute allegations against Islam, misconceptions about Quran. What better choice do you have to spread the truth of Islam than Peace TV?
support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donation to Islamic Research Foundation International, Islamic Bank of Britain, Coventry Road, Birmingham, UK. Account number 011-32301, sort code 300083.
Peaceful, peace.
Peace TV, the solution for humanity. Learn Quran, learn Hadith, learn Islam, the way to peace. Darus Salam, authentic Islamic books in world's major languages. A golden treasure for every library and every home. Darus Salam, global leader in Islamic books.
It is Ramadan.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome back to the show, Ramadan, a date with Dr. Zakir. I'm your host, Yusuf Chambers, and today we are discussing a topic, common errors committed by Muslims during the month of Ramadan. Dr. Zakir, can you mention briefly again, categorize the common errors made in the third category?
The common errors committed by Muslims in the third category, that is, errors regarding negligence in performing the fara'id, the obligatory duties in Islam, is that Muslims, many of them, they stay awake the full night. They have an early suhur, and these people, they do not offer the Fajr Salah. Missing Fajr Salah is a sin. Many of them, because they stay awake the full night, they sleep the full day, and they even miss their Zuhr and the Asr Salah, which is a grave sin. They're trying to acquire blessings, and you are neglecting the obligated duties, which is totally prohibited. Many of the Muslims, they do not give zakat. Those are supposed to give zakat. And zakat is one of the pillars of Islam, in which every Muslim who has a saving of the nisab level, that is, those who have a saving of 85 grams of gold, they should give 2.5% of their savings every lunar year in charity. It's called a zakat. And the fourth error in the third category is that most of the Muslims give zakat, but they do not calculate the zakat properly. As far as common errors committed by Muslim month of Ramadan, it is indulging in prohibited acts. The most common is, though these acts are prohibited for a Muslim, irrespective whether it's a month of Ramadan or non-Ramadan, but specifically, we should be more careful. We should be careful trying to avoid these acts throughout our life. But in Ramadan, we should be more careful. And the most common, number one, where Muslims involve themselves is backbiting and slandering. Backbiting is a grave sin. And Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Hujurat, chapter 49, verse number 12, that those who backbite, they are people who eat the dead meat of their own brother. So backbiting and slandering is one of the gravest sins. The second common error in this category is Muslims, many of them, they use false speech. They tell lies during the month of Ramadan. The third is they use abusive language, which is contrary to the spirit of Islam and of Ramadan. The fourth is they use vulgar language. And the fifth is they involve themselves in gossiping. The sixth is some of them involve in false action. The seventh is, many of the Muslims, to kill time, they listen to music and un-Islamic songs, which is totally prohibited in Islam. The eighth common error is, many of the Muslims, to kill time, they watch un-Islamic television programs and un-Islamic movies. The ninth common error committed by Muslim is that many of the Muslims, they read un-Islamic magazines, un-Islamic books, un-Islamic pictures, which are all prohibited in Islam. The tenth common error done by Muslims in this month is, many of them, they go to un-Islamic sites on the internet, which is again prohibited. The 11th common error is that they spend excessively and they commit extravagance. And the 12th is, there is a lot of wastage of food. So this was in brief regarding the list of mistakes done by Muslims commonly in the third category. That is, indulging in acts which are prohibited and neglecting acts which are farz in Islam.
So Dr. Zakir, what are the other common errors committed by Muslims during the month of Ramadan?
The other common errors committed by Muslims in the month of Ramadan, that is the fourth category, is number one is that many of the Muslims, they stay awake the full night and then they sleep in the day. And they do the normal activity the night time and sleep in the daytime. They're converting day into night and night into day, and the whole purpose of fasting is defeated. The second error in this category is that many of the Muslims, they remain lazy and they're inactive during the daytime, which is contrary to the spirit of fasting. The third common error is that many of the Muslims, they try and kill their time during the day by playing, by amusement, by games, which defeats the purpose again. The fourth common error is Muslims, they give lavish iftar parties and they spend a lot of money, mainly trying to show off. The fifth common error, many of the Muslims, they ask the women folk in their family to prepare a variety of dishes for iftar and for suhoor, thus making the women in the family spend the majority of the time in the kitchen. In fact, the family should spend most of the time in remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if the women folk do more du'as, inshallah, even the men will benefit. Even their sins will be forgiven, inshallah. The sixth common error is that many of the Muslims, they renovate their house and their shop in the month of Ramadan, spend more time in that than remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The seventh common error is that many of the Muslims, they spend their nights, instead of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in activities which are unproductive. For example, they spend their time in excessive socializing after Taraweeh. That's the eighth error. Ninth is, many of the Muslims, they spend many nights and most parts of their nights in shopping. The tenth common error is, many of the Muslims, they spend most of the time in the night in eating. The 11th is, many of the Muslims, they spend their time in robing and in loitering during the night. And the 12th common error is, the last 10 days of Ramadan are mainly the days in which the Muslims should do more ibadah. But most of the Muslims, they spend time in shopping, in celebrating, and preparing themselves for Eid. And most of them spend time in activities which are unproductive rather than spending the time in ibadah. These are some of the other common errors which Muslims commit, and I hope inshallah that they will abstain from these errors in future.
Inshallah. Ajmain. So the next question is, are there any common errors that you can mention relationship to culture and country?
All the errors that I mentioned earlier were general Muslims throughout the world. There are some errors which are made mainly by people living in certain country, belonging to certain culture. For example, in the Indian subcontinent, there are people living in India, in Pakistan, in Sri Lanka. During Ramadan, many of the Muslims, in the night, they play night cricket. And they spend most of the time in night cricket rather than doing ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this playing night cricket is more common in the Indian subcontinent. Now if you go to the Arab countries, especially the Gulf countries, there many of the offices, many of the working places, that is in the market, etc., they change their timings. they hardly work for a couple of hours in the daytime, and they open most of the time during night. So what happens? It encourages people to do shopping in the night rather than in the day, and they get more business, and they're inviting people rather in spending time in remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muslims spend their time in shopping, in eating during night time. And furthermore, those people who are employed in the shops, they are forced to come at night time because it's their duty. So these Muslims are even preventing their employees, rather than remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're involving themselves in business and spending most of their time in activities which are not according to the sunnah.
Well, jazakallah khair once again, Dr. Sakir Naik, for uncovering some of the misconceptions regarding common errors committed by Muslims during the month of Ramadan. Brothers and sisters, join us tomorrow for part two of Common Mistakes Committed During the Month of Ramadan. See you tomorrow at the same time. Assalamu alaikum.
حافظين ذاكرين قانتين خاشعين مسلمين مؤمنين للإله عابدين شهرنا صوم وعتق وقنوت فيه صدق يومنا صبر ورق بدموع البائسين رمضان قد أهل بالصيام وأطل مسعدا أهلا وخلا لكه في كل
A friendly message by Dr. Zakir. The Islamic bomb.
Islam comes from the Arabic root word salam or salam, which means peace. It is also derived from the root word silm, which means to submit your will to Almighty God. People worry that one day nuclear weaponry will fall in the hands of the Arabs. They fail to realize that the Islamic bomb, the bomb of peace, has already been dropped. It fell the day Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was born.
Peace TV, the solution for humanity.